Sri Ram, hearing the words of Jamvan, he embraces Hanuman. He raises lagaya aur kaha ki he tat Janki ji kis prakar se apne pranon ko raksha karte hain. Sri Ram embraces Hanuman and says, Hanuman, how is Janki ji, Sita Devi, spending her days? And Hanuman recounts the condition of Sita. आपका नाम रात दिन पहरा देता है और आपका ध्यान किवार है और जानकी जी के नेत्र अर्थात आंखों जो पांव की ओर लगे हैं वही कपाट को ताला है, इससे प्राण निकलने का मार्ग नहीं पाता. हनुमान एक्सप्लेन्स, ओ लॉर्ड, डू यू नो हाउ सीता इज स्पेंडिंग अ डेज इन द अशोक वाटिका हेल्ड देयर एंड केप्ट देयर बाय रावण. Your name keeps watch night and day. Continuous thought of you act like a pair of closed doors. Her eyes are fastened on her feet. Her life force finds no way to escape. This is how Sita Devi is languishing away in Ashok Vatika. Friends, the words of Hanuman tonight act as a guide to us if we want to become a liberated soul. Look at the condition of Sita. She was carried away by Ravan. But even so, in Ashok Vatika, in the golden city of resplendence and plenty, that city in which there is so much merriment and material things to bring joy to the mind of all, Sita Devi finds no peace, no happiness. In other words, she is spending her days not indulging in the pleasures of the senses, not enjoying the luxuries of earthly existence, as it were, but thinking of Sri Ramchandraji. And so too, look at it. Sita Devi has erred. She has made a mistake. What does she do? Does she continue in the error of her ways? She repents. And it is this repentance that will captivate the heart of Sri Ramchandraji. Friends, even we as devotees, we have gone wrong in many ways in our own lives. Is it that God condemns us? No, my friends. God is always willing to lend a helping hand to that individual who needs it and who longs for it. And this is the condition of Sita, coming to terms with the error of her ways and the reality of her mistake. She now repents. And what form her repentance takes? She is thinking of the name of God. Aapka naam Radin Paranditai. She's always repeating your holy name, friends. And this is how you too can come back. And this is how you can become the endeared one of God. If you will constantly repeat His holy name with the mind concentrated upon Him. They said, Bhagwan ka naam ka setu hai, jis par manush arohan karke bhav sagar ko paar ho jate hain. The name of Sri Ramchandraji serves as a veritable bridge to help us cross the ocean of worldly existence. The name of God serves as a veritable boat to take us safely across the other end of the shore of worldly existence. And if we as devotees want God to save us and to rescue us, we who are sinking in the ocean of sin, then we must be devoted and dedicated to the name of God. Aapka naam, the name of the Lord. Your name keeps watch night and day. The thought and the entire consciousness of Sita is soaked in the name divine. Continuous thought of you act like a pair of closed doors. Look at it again. In spite of the glitter and glamour of Lanka, Sita Devi is not attracted to that. Her mind is soaked in the consciousness of God. Her thoughts are all enwrapped in the presence of Bhagwan Sri Ramachandraji. And she has placed the form of Sri Ramachandraji within the chamber of her heart, and she has locked that door. How did she lock it? By her eyes fastened on her feet. Her eyes were now not attracted by anything that is worldly. But her eyes fastened on her feet means the world of external attractions have no effect now upon her. Her eyes upon her feet. All this go to show one important quality that can lead us to God. Love. Love for God. Hanuman describes here tonight the great love that Sita Devi has for Sri Ramachandraji. How do you interpret this? You can see the love of one life partner for another at the worldly level. But at a higher spiritual level, you can see the love of a devotee whose mind has been filled with the feeling of repentance as that devotee now turns to God. We see the great love that fills the heart of Sita Devi for Sri Ramachandraji. That love which cannot be a separation. That love which longs for oneness with the object of adoration. Do you really love God? Tell me sincerely, do you love God? All of us will say yes. Why do you love God? Why? There are four types of people who love God. Those who are in distress, you pray to God because He can relieve you of your distress. You love Him because He can bring relief to you in moments of distress. Sure, that's great. You love God because you know He can fulfill your wish and desires. And so you look to Him for fulfillment. Maybe you love God because you are tired of the suffering of earthly existence. And you want to gain liberation, freedom from the cycle of birth and death. Sure, you love God. And you may love God because of the natural magnetic force within your heart that pulls you towards Him. Not for relief, not for fulfillment of wishes and desires, not for liberation, but because of the pure, unadulterated love that fills your heart. Which kind of these four type of love do you have for God? Maybe not the last one, but the best is the last. The natural love that pulls you to God. This is the kind of love here. Maybe you'll say, okay, Sita has erred and she wants now to, once again, to become one with Sri Ram. So she's praying to Him and she's longing for Him. Sure, but the love that fills her heart is what is called transcendental love. The kind of love that Bhagwan Sri Krishna has exemplified in the pages of the Bhagavatam as He lived and sported with His Gopanagwal on the bank of the holy Yamuna. It is that kind of love which we should develop. You know, very often, if you look at the love that we have for fellow human beings, for relatives, you can see that that is a selfish love. Isn't that so? What do you think? Is it selfish or is it selfless? Look at an individual. Let us say that your mother or your father dies. Look at an individual crying. Why did the person cry? Is it that person is sorry for the mother or the father? Or is it that person is going to miss the mother and the father? Miss, isn't that so? And if you're going to miss, then who is it you're sorry for? Not for yourself? So you cry for yourself? It's a selfish love that you'll have for your friends and your relatives. But the kind of love that you should have for God is selfless, unadulterated. Don't look for anything in return. You constantly pray to Him because of the natural love that fills your heart. Sita Devi, as she remains there in Ashok Bhadika, she pines for oneness with Bhagavan Sri Ram. Hanumanji says, Lord, Sita Devi is wasting away in Lanka. Let us go and rescue her. It also represents the fact that a true devotee of God always longs for oneness with the object of adoration, Sita.